In the last session, we understood about SQL functions. With SQL functions, the only issue, I would not call it as an issue, SQL functions actually work on all the rows inside the table. If you try to give a hike, if you try to perform an arithmetic operation on a salary column, it actually increases the salary of all the employees. That means the function will impact all the rows, right? And let's take, if you want to change the case of the employee name, like from lowercase to uppercase or uppercase to lowercase or lowercase to title case, it will change all the records inside the table. And this is the reason all the SQL functions that we have seen earlier are known as single row functions. So what is the exact definition of single row functions? These functions will impact all the rows inside a table. Let me give you an example if you guys have forgot the functions. So select upper first name from hr.employees. And now we already know that. What mistake did I do? Okay, that's the mistake. We already know that employee table has 107 records, correct? Now if you see, all the 107 records have been impacted. That means this upper function will apply to all the records inside the table. And this is the reason all the functions that we have seen earlier, those are known as single row functions. Now the question is, do we also have multiple row functions? Yes, we do have multiple row functions. What are these multiple row functions? These are the functions that will impact multiple rows and give you one single output, right? Now, what could be multiple row functions? I'm just trying to guess before I talk about multiple row functions that we have. For example, you want to add all the salaries of the employees. That means you want to sum up. You want to sum up all the salaries and find out what is the total salaries you are paying to all your employees. Now, in this case, you are adding up all the records, but your result is one. That means multiple row functions will take multiple records, but they will give you only one single output. So, operates on multiple rows and give you one single output. One example was sum. Let's take, I want to add up all the salaries of the employees. So let me query the HR table. hr.employees. Now, what if you want to find out the average salary for all the employees? Correct? What if you want to find out the minimum salary or the employee whose salary is least? Or you want to find out an employee whose salary is the highest. Now these kind of functions, they take multiple rows, they take entire table or sometimes part of the table depending on how you write the query. And the rows that get into these kind of functions, they take up all the data and then give you one single output. So what are these multiple row functions? The first one is average. That's defined by AVG. It will give you average of the data that you put into the function. Next is count. It will give you the total count of the records. And then next is min. Min is nothing but minimum. Then we have max. And finally, we have sum. These are also known as group functions, because they group your records and give you one single output. So I would rather call them group slash multiple row functions, because the actual word is group functions, but I kind of like manipulated it to multiple row functions. So these all are group functions that we have. We will be seeing some examples for all these functions, because these are very simple functions. Once you know how to use them, it's easy to apply into your data set.